In this video, I'm going to finish the Solving Quadratic Functions with Square Roots worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. In this video, we'll finish numbers 21 through 28. Picking up where we left off with number 21, I'm going to start by adding 7 to both sides. That'll give me that 5n squared is equal to 495, since 488 plus 7 equals 495. Now, when I divide by 5, I'll get that n squared is equal to a positive 99. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that n is equal to the square root of 99. Now remember, the square root of a positive number can be two separate numbers. It can be positive and it can be negative. So the square root of 99 is 9.949, which I'll round to 9.950. Although on the worksheet answer key, they keep it at 9.949. But because there's an 8 after that third decimal place, I'm going to round up to 50. So we'll have a positive 9.950 and a negative 9.950. Since either of those squared will equal a positive 99. Because remember, a negative times a negative is a positive. And number 22, we'll start by adding 6 to both sides. So that will give us 8n squared on the left equal to 312 on our right. Dividing both sides by 8, I'll get that n squared is equal to 39. Now I'll take the square root of both sides, so n will be equal to the square root of 39. Typing that into my calculator, the square root of 39, I'll get 6.2449, which on the worksheet, they round down to 6.244, but I will be rounding up to 6.245. So 6.245 and negative 6.245 are my solutions for number 22 for the variable n. And number 23, we'll add 10 to both sides at the start. So that will give us 10n squared equal to 480. Dividing both sides by 10, I'll get that n squared is equal to 48. So now I'm just going to take the square root of both sides. So n will be equal to the square root of 48. And in decimal form, the square root of 48 is equal to 6.928. And there's a 2 after that 8, so I'll be rounding down. So I'll have positive 6.928 and negative 6.928 as my solutions for this quadratic equation in number 23. In number 24, let's add 4 to both sides at the start. So we'll have 8n squared equal to 536. So now when I divide by 8, I'll get that n squared is equal to 67. So taking the square root of both sides, I'll get n all by itself on the left equal to the square root of 67. Typing that into my calculator, I'll get 8.1853, which rounds to 8.185, and negative 8.185. Now that we're about halfway through this video, here's a quick reminder to click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Let's continue on to number 25. For number 25, we'll start by subtracting 1. So we'll have 4r squared equal to 324. Now we'll divide by 4 to get that r squared is equal to 81. And r is equal to the square root of 81 when I take the square root of both sides. And because 81 is a perfect square, I know that my solution is 9 and negative 9 for r, since 9 squared is 81 and negative 9 squared is 81. And number 26 will begin by adding 7 at the start. So 8b squared is equal to 200. Now when I divide by 8, I'll get that b squared is equal to 25. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get b is equal to the square root of 25. And 25, again, is a perfect square. So that will be a whole number 5 and negative 5 as my solutions. So 5 times 5 equals 25, and negative 5 times negative 5 equals a positive 25. And number 27, since this 2 is subtracted, we're going to add it to both sides to cancel it out. So 2k squared equals 146. Dividing by 2, I'll get that k squared is equal to 146 divided by 2, which is 73. Taking the square root of both sides, I'll get that k is equal to the square root of 73. Typing that into my calculator, I'll get 8.5440, which rounds to 8.544. However, that's a positive 8.544 and a negative 8.544. And lastly on this video, number 28. For this problem, I'll subtract 3 from both sides. So I'll have negative 4x squared, since that 4x is subtracted, equal to negative 85 minus 3, which is negative 88. Dividing both sides by negative 4, I'll get that x squared is equal to a positive 22. So now, when I take the square root of both sides, I'll have that x is equal to the square root of positive 22. And the square root of 22 is 4.6904, which rounds to 4.69. So that's a positive 4.69 and a negative 4.69 as my final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.